Further, we are going to add an additional capacity of 619 megawatts of solar power to the grid by April 2016. I wish to inform the House that the works on floating storage and regasification and the gas pipeline from Kakinada to Visakhapatnam will commence during 2016-17, and city gas distribution in East Godavari, West Godavari and Krishna district will also commence in 2016-17. This will mark the initial stage of the gas grid in the state. Our government is also committed to ensuring energy security to the BPL women who are still reeling under the smoke of the wood burning in their cooking stoves. Therefore, we offered 11 lakh Deepam connections in 2015-16. We are committed to ensure that all households are provided with LPG in 2016-17. I have provided 4,020.31 crores to the Energy and Infrastructure Department in the 2016-17 budget. Fiber grid. Broadband revolution is an important instrument through which our government seeks to transform Andhra Pradesh. A World Bank study has found that 10% increase in broadband penetration in low and middle income countries has resulted in a 1.38% increase in GDP. In an area where internet is fast becoming a human right, we see a significant need for providing broadband access for faster development and to reduce digital inequalities. Therefore, our government has taken up a program to lay the fiber grid across the state that would provide 10 to 15 Mbps connectivity before the end of 2016 with an outlay of 320 crores. I am proud to inform this August House that the Andhra Pradesh is the first state to do so, and the Union Government is seeking our support to implement a similar project across the country. Housing sector. Construction sector registered 9.46% growth over the previous year, 2015. The housing sector is slated to become an important growth driver in the state. Every lakh invested in housing is expected to generate around 4 jobs in the economy directly or indirectly. Further, every rupee invested in housing sector will add 1.54 rupees to GSDP, and with household expenditure, this can go up to 2.84 rupees. Therefore, our government is committed to providing housing for all by 2022. This requires a total of 10 lakh houses in urban areas and 30 lakh houses in rural areas to achieve this vision between 2016 and 2022. In pursuant of this vision, we have launched NTR housing scheme by increasing the subsidy 6 times to 1,25,000 for general category beneficiaries and 8 times to 1,75,000 for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe beneficiaries with a total unit cost of 2,75,000 rupees. These houses will be equipped with all major requirements like tiled flooring and kitchen platforms, etc. Under Pradhan Mantri Yojana, Awas Yojana, we received approvals from Government of India for 1,20,106 economically weak section houses and in principle approval for another 73,041 EWC houses for beneficiaries-led construction. In total, we will take up 110 projects in 59 urban local bodies with a total project cost of 10,623 crores to ensure that beneficiaries face minimal hassles in constructing their houses. We are providing support for raw materials, facilitating supply of cement at concessional rates by negotiating directly with the cement companies, geotagging, imparting training to construction personnel, construction demo projects, reflecting various technological options, transferring stage-wise payments electronically, etc. I have earmarked 1,132.83 crores for the housing sector with focus on a eco-section housing program. In addition, we intend to resort to extra budgetary resource mobilization by the Housing Corporation in partnership with the central government and housing and infrastructure financial institutions. Human development. We believe every citizen is entitled to access to quality education, health care, and nutrition security, as they are the most critical services essential for human development. These human development functions form the foundation of any inclusive society. The reason we are committed to their promotion in letter and spirit, we are committed to improving the human development index of Andhra Pradesh by implementing the sustainable development strategy. School education. Our government envisions a society where every child has access to quality education. In pursuit of this vision, we have undertaken several initiatives. We have filled vacancies of teachers, implemented the school information management system with a rigorous monitoring of student-teacher performance based on key performance indicators, rationalized the schools for optimal utilization of resources, revised the curriculum to be in time with the emerging requirements, introduced art and yoga for all-round development, etc. We have partnered with institutions of repute such as Aisha Foundation, MIT Abdul Latif, Jamil Poverty Action, and Pratham to help us improve quality outcomes. Our education campaign, Badi Pilustondi, has focused on preventing school dropouts and resorting the dropouts to the stream of education. As a result of our initiatives, we lowered the school dropout, increased the pupil-teacher ratio, thus improved the learning outcomes. As a result of our initiatives, the dropout rate at a high school level has dropped from 25.23% in 2014-15 to 23.87% in 2015-16. The pupil-teacher ratio at secondary level has improved from 23 to 22 and primary level from 21 to 19. In 2016-17, we intend to bring down the high school dropout rate to at least 21.5%. I am providing 17,502.65 crores for the promotion of secondary education in 2016-17 budget, which amounts to about 12.9% of the total BE for the year and an increase of 12.5% over 2015-16 budget estimates. Higher education. Our government has been instrumental in getting sanction for 7 institutions of higher education from Government of India, of which 5 have become operational in record time. They include IIT, IIIT, NIT, IISER, and IIM. We have facilitated the way for private sector to establish higher education institutions through the Private University Bill, which was passed by this House. Further, we are establishing collaborations with the international institutions like National University of Singapore, University of California at Berkeley, etc. We have also ensured that for the first time, Andhra University has been ranked globally amongst the top universities. Collegiate and technical education. To enhance the employability of our graduates, we have fostered a long-term partnership with the Tata Institute of Social Sciences for a 3-year parallel degree program wherein they are imparted management skills and soft skills. We are also imparting IT communication and soft skills through Jawar Knowledge Centers, English language labs, etc. We are also offering apprenticeship training to students to local training to students in vocal education, vocational education. We are implementing quality reforms in a higher education arena, such as introducing choice-based credit system, updating the curriculum to enhance employability, filling vacancies of faculty, introducing key performance indicators, grading the colleges, etc. To increase excellence amongst students and lecturers, government has initiated Yuvatarangam and Pratibha Awards. I am providing 2,644.64 crores in the 2016-17 financial year budget estimates for the promotion of technical, collegiate and higher education. Healthcare. Our government's principal objective is to ensure affordable health care to its citizens, to the citizens, duly ensuring equitable access to health care. In this direction, we have strengthened the existing programs like NTR, Vaidya Seva, which offers 1,044 surgical and medical procedures to the poor people, 108 for emergency health services, 104 for fixed day mobile health services, family welfare programs under National Health Mission, etc. In addition, we have launched new programs such as E-Aushadi 102 Talli Bidda Express for maternal and child health, NTR Vaidya Parisha, Tele Radiology, etc. The bifurcation has resulted in significant loss of tertiary care institutions. Our government has secured sanctions for AIIMS at Mangalagiri, which is under construction. The commissioning of Visakhapatnam Institute of Medical Sciences and Sri Padmavati Government Medical College for Women at Tirupati is under progress. The government is also implementing Employees Health Scheme, which provides cashless treatment to all the government employees, pensioners and their dependent family members through a network of empaneled hospitals. While retaining focus on strengthening the public health sector, we are also facilitating the establishment of private medical institutions. I am proposing an allocation of 6,103.76 crores in the 2016-17 budget for the health sector, with a plan outlay being increased from 1986.80 crores in 2015-16 financial year to 2,933.73 crores in 2016-17 financial year. Food and nutritional security. Our government is committed to ensuring food and nutritional security of every citizen, especially of women and children. The high prevalence of malnutrition and micronutrient deficiency amongst women and children is unacceptable to the government, and therefore it accords high priority to addressing this vexatious problem. As part of the integrated child development, supplementary nutritional program is being provided to 26.45 lakh children and 8.56 lakh pregnant and lactating women. We are also implementing Anna Amruta Hastam, which provides one full meal to pregnant and nursing mothers in 104 high burden ICDS projects with a high IMR, MMR and low birth babies. This scheme was availed by 3.45 lakh mothers at an expenditure of 91.04 crores in 2015-16. I propose an allocation of 772 crores for ICDS, with a significant increase of 45%. A new scheme, Girigoru Muddalu, with a special and supervised feeding, was launched on August 15, 2015 to meet the nutritional needs of children in tribal areas in the age of 6 months to 6 years. This has benefited 1,33,733 children in tribal areas. We will sustain this scheme and continue to cover all children in this age group. While the above initiatives cover preschool children and pregnant and lactating mothers, we recognize the importance of midday meals scheme in not only improving the nutritional status of children but also in reducing school dropout rate. Therefore, we intend to expand the nutrition content of the midday meals by including an egg every day. I propose an allocation of 750 crores for midday meals in 2016-17, which is an increase of 67% over 2015-16. Public distribution system. We are committed to providing nutritional security to all BPL families. In addition to those covered under the ICDS, AAH and GGG, we are providing essential commodities to 4.01 crore people through the public distribution system, with an expenditure of 2,459.39 crores in 2015-16. In 2016-17, this expenditure is estimated to be 2,702.20 crores. To ensure the prices of essential commodities do not hurt the purchasing power of citizens, we are intervening in the market where necessary. We have automated the public distribution system during 2015 and intend to strengthen the delivery system and plug the deficiencies in 2016-17. poverty alleviation and empowerment. I recall with all sincerity at my command what President Franklin D. Roosevelt said, "The test of our progress is not whether we add more to the abundance of those who have much. It is whether we provide enough for those who have little." Indeed, this is the test of our government would pass with flying colors. Our government believes that poverty alleviation and empowerment of all socially and economically weaker sections is a way to build a just and fair society. With this belief, we are making earnest efforts to eradicate poverty in the state by 2029. Scheduled caste welfare and empowerment. We are undertaking various programs for the educational advancement, socio-economic development, welfare and protection of the scheduled caste. We are providing pre-matric and post-matric scholarships, educating children in the best available schools in English medium, hostel accommodation for those coming from distant places for pursuing education, financial support to students going abroad for higher studies and under Ambedkar Overseas Vidya Nidhi, professional guidance for civil social service aspirants under NTR Vidyonnati, skill upgradation for professional graduates and placement linked skill development for youth under Chandranna Chayota. We propose to convert all hostels into residential schools in a phased manner to improve the education outcomes. In addition, in addition to education programs, we are providing economic support schemes for the economic development of SC families. We are also providing subsidized power to SC households whose electricity consumption is less than 50 units a month. I am allocating 8,724 crores for the welfare and development of the scheduled caste in 2016-17 financial year, which represents an increase of 59% over the 2015-16 allocation. Of this, 2,382.27 crores is allocated to the Social Welfare Department and 6,342 crores is allocated as the scheduled caste sub-plan amongst all major departments for the purpose of scheduled caste welfare and development. Scheduled tribes welfare and empowerment. We are committed to the holistic development of scheduled tribes, considering the low literacy levels amongst the tribal people. We are providing quality education to all tribal children through ashram and residential schools, pre- and post-matric scholarships, skill development programs for youth, etc. I am proposing an allocation of 3,100 crores for the welfare and development of scheduled tribes in 2016-17, which represents an increase of 75% over the 2015-16 budget provision. Of this, 980 crores is being allocated to the Tribal Welfare Department and the remaining 2,120 crores is being allocated as the tribal sub-plan to all major departments for the development programs that would benefit the scheduled tribes. Backward caste welfare and empowerment. Our government is committed to the welfare and all-around development of backward class. We are implementing a number of educational programs for the BC students like hostels, Mahatma Jyoti Rao Phule, BC Residential Schools, scholarships, coaching for competitive examinations, and skill development programs for youth. The scholarship programs benefited 6,49,573 students in 2015-16. In the 2016-17 budget, I am providing 8,832 crores for the welfare and development of backward class, which represents an increase of 31.5%. This represents 17.76% of the total plan allocation in 2016-17. Of this, I am earmarking 3,047 crores directly to the BC Welfare Department and the remaining 5,678 crores is being apportioned amongst all major departments for the welfare and development activities that would directly benefit the members of backward classes. Minorities welfare and empowerment. Considering the educational and economic backwardness of the minority communities, we are implementing a number of education programs like residential education scholarship skill development programs for youth. With an expenditure of 8 crores, We imparted skills to 5,714 candidates of minority community in 2015-16 with a placement rate of 70% and an average salary of 6,250 per month. In addition, we are implementing the Sadikana scheme and assisting hospital pilgrims. We have implemented economic support benefit schemes benefiting 14,287 beneficiaries with an expenditure of 48 crores in 2015-16. In 2016-17, we intend to assist 1 lakh families with an outlay of 250 crores. We will provide major impetus to the welfare and development of the minorities in 2016-17 financial year and thereafter. I am providing 710.57 crores for the welfare and development of minorities in 2016-17, which represents an increase of 87.53% over the 2015-16 allocation of 378.81 crores. Other caste development. Our government has recognized the need for empowerment of other communities which are economically advanced and have taken measures for their upliftment. In this direction, we established the Andhra Pradesh Kapu Welfare and Development Corporation and the Andhra Pradesh Brahmin Welfare Corporation in 2015-16. During 2015-16, we have assisted 12,000 Brahmin families to advance economically. We propose to enable 50,000 Brahmin families to progress economically in 2016-17. For this purpose, I am allocating 65 crores as grant to the AP Brahmin Corporation, which represents an increase of 85.7% over 2015-16 financial year. Similarly, my government is committed to the all-round development of families belonging to the Kapu caste. We assisted 32,000 family Kapu families with an outlay of 100 crores during 2015-16 to help them advance on the economic front. I am allocating 1,000 crores to the Kapu Development Corporation, an increase of 10 times the allocation in 2015-16. Social security assistance, social sector pensions. Our government is committed to ensuring a life of grace and dignity to all the poor and vulnerable, particularly the old and infirm. To support the minimum needs of these persons and to bring happiness in their lives, we introduced the NTR Bharosa program by enhancing the social security pension by 5